10. This week, dozens of volunteers head out attempting to contact and count the area's homeless population, one person at a time. Tonight, we're getting our first look at the increasing numbers, and you might be surprised to find out the places some end up calling home. NBC 15's Chris Woodard has more.
There are toys, comfortable beds, and plenty to eat. But despite the appearances, this isn't how Gloria Rivera imagined raising her young child.
If it was just me, I could kind of go on the streets or, you know, with other friends. But with having a baby, it makes it a little more difficult because, you know, she needs a roof over her head. I don't want her to just be sleeping in a car.
Rivera is one of hundreds of homeless in Rock County. And even she admits she's actually one of the lucky ones.
I'm immensely grateful because if it wasn't for this place, like I said, I don't know where I'd be.
Rivera found temporary help here at the House of Mercy, one of several homeless shelters in Janesville. Many more spend their time on the streets. According to Community Action Incorporated, in the last 4 years, Rock County's homeless population increased 37% from 264 to 403. But exact numbers are hard to come by. That's why they need this.
Shampoo, toiletries, toothpaste, toothbrushes.
A homeless count. 45 volunteers hit the streets, bringing homeless people care packages.
We have a kit for mail as well.
And reporting what they find.
When they come across them, it is pretty eye-opening.
Numbers from local shelters are still coming in, but volunteers found 17 people on the street earlier this week, including 8 camping under an overpass near a creek. In this parking lot, they even have a sign that clearly states, you can't bring your car here and park just to sleep. But the people that go out and do these counts say you would be surprised what they find. At Walmarts in both Janesville and Beloit, homeless people were found sleeping in cars. It's where Rivera says she'd probably be if it wasn't for the House of Mercy. In Janesville, Chris Woodard, NBC 15 News.
Now, counts like this are mandated by the government, but the reality is they only begin to scratch the surface. By coming up with actual numbers of homeless people, the state gets a better chance of bringing in money to help them and fund things like shelter.